What's up, guys? It's your boy Chance. I know it's late. I've been up and down for the last few days because, as you guys may or may not be able to tell, even though I've been trying to do some recording, I am a bit sick, so I've been up and down a lot. But there's some stuff I'd like to settle, not only about my artwork, but about the music industry in general that I've been seeing that needs to be changed. And, like, I'm not doing this as a rant to repeat myself. I'm doing this because there needs to be change in the community of music, as well as those that are, you know, judging my art. First off, I just want to say what's up to everybody. I love you guys. But this guy named Race King on YouTube basically reported me to the art police for stealing a piece of art that he said wasn't mine. It was my samurai geisha girl that I did several years ago. You know, I did this really cool samurai geisha piece several years ago and stuff, and he got bounced around a lot on, you know, on DeviantArt, Facebook, Google, everywhere, basically. Got bounced around a lot. And, you know, I've had some people, you know, share it, put my name on it, tag me in it, and then I've also had those that have laid claim to it and this and that. Well, this dude basically reported me saying that it wasn't mine. And it's like, dude, my artwork is my own. Now, I do want to say thank you to the artists over at Bloodshot Records. You know, Ian Duxworth, Aiden Schroeder, and, you know, everybody on BSR that stood up for me, man. You guys are fucking awesome. And this dude's been bashing me and trying to claim my name and talk all kinds of shit for a while now. And it's like, dude, like, what do you think that you're doing, you know, by calling the art police? Like, they're not gonna do anything because I'm a well-known artist. Like, I've earned the respect of many. So, fair warning to you, man, like, the art cops aren't gonna do a damn thing because they know me, they know my work, they know who I am. So really, they're not gonna do anything new. So you're basically wasting your time by calling the cops like that, man. Like, seriously, by getting a hold of the art police and, like, by getting a hold of the people that run a good majority of the art or the art community, like, dude, you're wasting your time and your energy doing that, because everybody knows that the artwork I put up is my own. I don't steal art. My artwork is my own. And anybody that knows me can tell you that, because everybody here knows my style. They know how I do. Just because I put up a few, you know, fancy pieces that aren't abstract art, that doesn't mean it's not mine. So what if I want to put up some of my best work from time to time? There's nothing wrong with that. But you need to stop being a little fucking bitch and calling the goddamn cops every time I put up a really good piece that you're getting pissed off about, because you want to sit there and try to be me. You want to try to claim me. You want to say that you're the best in the world at everything. You're basically trying to not only go as a racing style gamer, but you're basically trying to be me in general. Like, you're trying to get your hands on my art, basically take over my life, and that's not going to happen, dude. Okay? I've earned the respect of many people within the car community. I've earned the respect of some of the best drivers in the gaming community in the world. On top of some of the best artists in the world within the art community on DeviantArt, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. I've earned the respect of a lot of people. And for you to try to tarnish that reputation, where's that fair? I understand that you enjoy what I do, man. And I thank you for that, dude. But there's no reason to go out and try to fucking do what you do just because I called you out when you tried to pretend to be me. I called you out for a reason, dude. Because you tried to pretend to be me. You tried to take over my life. And you tried to lay claim to a status that I earned, that I worked really, really hard for many years on getting. Okay, I built my reputation from the ground up, and I'm not about to let someone, a punk bitch on YouTube, thinking that he's hot shit, you know, bully me and screw me like that. It ain't happening, dude. It's ridiculous. Oh. Oh, man. Oh. Sorry, y'all. I can't stop laughing, man. It's ridiculous. It's hilarious. I'd seen this guy try to claim my name and my rep. Like, it's funny. Like, it's funny. If you hear me choking, don't worry about it. I'm dying laughing because this dude really honestly thinks that he can be me. Like, this dude honestly thinks that he's the best racer in the world. This guy thinks that, you know, I don't own the Shadowblade name, that, you know, I don't have it copywritten when I do. Like, dude, I got that shit trademarked and copywritten. Like, come on, dude. Like, who the fuck you fooling? Now, onto a bigger subject that not only is about myself and the special needs community, it's about music artists in general. And the reason why I'm bringing this up is because I've had a lot of record labels, such as RCA, I've had WB, I've had several record labels attack me because I took shots at the mainstream industry. Because they didn't like what I did. They didn't like how I called them out. Well, I guarantee you guys, what I did for a very good reason. I called you guys out in the mainstream music industry. I called you guys out because you guys are committing so much fucked up, morally wrong stuff. You guys might not think that you are, but really you are. You're not only morally screwing with people, but you're also basically stealing from people. Now, before you go and, you know, start laughing your ass off, allow me to explain how you're doing all this. First off, you sit there and you tell artists that they have to pay a certain amount to sign to your label. That's step one. And then step two, once they do pay and then they do, you do sign them, you know, you try to pull them in that direction and mold them into somebody that you want them to be. You don't allow them to speak the truth. You don't allow them to put out music that actually helps people. You force them to put out this cookie cutter bullshit music that ain't even really any good. But yeah, there's like very few songs out there that's in the mainstream industry that I will listen to. There's a very select few. But you guys basically tell these people, you basically rob them and then try to make them into somebody that they don't want to be. And you force them to sing your bullshit songs. And I think I speak for every music artist in the industry when I tell you we've had enough of this shit. We've had enough of you guys trying to make us into people that you want us to be. We're tired of you stealing from us. All right. What happened to back in the day when an artist used to get signed to a record label for free? And that record label would help develop them and then take money out of their paycheck each month for however much they needed to put towards, distribution, shows, concerts, and stuff like that. Why can't we go back to that? And everybody wonders why I'm not signed. This is exactly why right here. Because every artist, every fucking label that wants me to pay money. I'm sorry, dude, but what you guys need to realize is that 99.9% of your artists out there, they don't have money. They're broke as hell. Like, they don't have anything. A lot of them, like myself, come from poor families. And you guys probably think, well, how does that make me money? Like, how am I supposed to make money off my artist? Simple. You sign the artist for free. All right, you bring them on for free. Don't make them pay a dime. Send them the contract, have them sign it, or they can go there, have them sign it. They give it to you, or they send it back to you in the mail. And then for the first few months of them getting out there and doing their shows, you take money out of your own pocket to help them. Okay? You take that money and you basically, put that towards their first time show, their stuff like that, and you basically help them kickstart their stuff. And then once they're kickstarted and they're making money, once they start making some money, then what you do is every month you take, say, 30, 40% of whatever that artist makes, and then you give them the rest of it. You take that little bit and then you put that towards distribution. You put that towards, stuff that they'll need to help keep them going. And then you just give them the rest. Whatever is left over, you send out to them for their bills, their families, stuff like that. And then to boot, you guys sit there and you turn down extremely talented artists. And then you sit there and you try to overcharge them. Like, the last label that tried to sign me was not only Street Records, and they wanted like $80 a month. Dude, I don't have 80 fucking dollars a month. Like, you guys are ripping people off. And honestly, I'm tired of seeing it. And all of us artists in general are sick of seeing it. We're sick of being ripped off. We're sick of being lied to. We're sick of being made into people that you want us to be instead of you allowing us to be who we are and putting out real music. Not this cookie cutter crap, idiotic bullshit gangster rap nonsense. Nobody wants to hear that. What the world wants to hear is music that helps people. What the world wants to hear is songs that can help them get through hard times. Songs that they can relate to. That's what the world really wants to hear. And that's what y'all need to wake up and see. Yeah, y'all might have more experience in the music industry, but guess what? You can have all the experience in the world, but that experience don't mean a fucking thing. That experience don't mean shit in the long run. What does mean something though is you helping your fellow artists out. Helping them get somewhere, helping them to develop their style, their sound. Helping them grow. That's what music should be. But instead, it comes down to you greedy motherfuckers constantly talking shit, saying that, you know, we're too cheap, that we're a dime a dozen. Nah, motherfucker. Artists like myself, Bradley, you know, we're not a dime a dozen. No artist is a dime a dozen. Because those of us that are real, that have real things to speak about, we're not easy to come by. Some of us are the most talented in the world. And yet you sit there and you pass us by like we don't matter. You shit on us like we don't mean a damn thing to you. Well, I think I speak for every single artist out there that's being fucked over by you guys when I say enough is enough and we're not taking it no more. I'm sick of seeing good people being screwed over because you guys want to be greedy little fucking bastards. I'm sick and tired of seeing you guys rip off good people. What happened to helping your fellow artists? What happened to helping your fellow man? Yeah, you might not want to hear those, you know, the sad sob stories, and that's fine, that's whatever. But guess what? A lot of those sob stories is what helped get those artists to where they're at. Because maybe if you start shutting your fucking mouths and opening up your ears, you know, maybe you'll realize just where a lot of these artists come from and some of the backgrounds that they came from, what helped them get to where they're at. Because see, you guys don't care to get to know the artists. All you see is money, and that's not right. You need to start seeing your artists, talk to your artists, get to know each one of them individually. You know, become friends with them. Don't sit there and just act like they're just another fucking dollar bill in your pocket. Because, you know, a lot of you motherfucking mainstream assholes out there that don't give a fuck, you guys were there once. You guys started out with nothing. And you guys know it. So honestly, it's time you guys paid up. We've been taking this shit for far too long. Myself and all of us in the music industry that you have turned down, we've taken shit for far too long. And now it's time for you guys to pay up, and it's our time to fight back against you. Your turn is done. It's time for those of us that you turned down, that you shunned, that you pushed aside. Now is our time to shine. You guys are so fucking stupid because you cast aside those that you don't think can make it. When in reality, those that you don't think can make it are really the ones that are going to make it. They're the ones that are going to push further than anyone. The ones that you don't think have what it takes, they're the ones that push every day. Sleepless nights, sleepless days. You know, screaming till their lungs are sore. They're the ones that put in double the hard work. Double the effort, just like myself. But yeah, what do? You decide to cast them aside like they're nothing. When really, the ones that should be cast aside are you guys. The owners of the mainstream industry. Because what you're doing to these people and to myself isn't fair at all. And you guys say that they need to pay to play? No, you don't. They do not have to pay to play. I shouldn't have to. Nobody should have to pay a label to be signed. Can I tell you something? You guys making these people sign, these people pay to sign to your guys' label? It's stupid. That's the way you making them pay to be signed is like, you paying your boss saying, hey, here's my payment. I want to work for you. You're basically making these people pay you to work for you when you should be paying them to work for you, not them pay you. You should be paying them. I get that you guys need to make your money somewhere. And like I said, take a little bit out of each artist's paycheck each month. That makes more sense. Work with the artist. Try to come to a mutual agreement on a set amount that, you will take out each month from that artist's paycheck to put towards, distribution. Show bookings, promo, tour dates, all that. Do that instead of stealing from these artists. Do that instead of ripping off these artists. Because there's a lot of good talent out there. A lot of good talent. And some of them I've come across, and some of them are some of the most talented people in the world. Some of the most talented people in the world. And yet, what do? You turn them down like they don't mean a damn thing. And some of that talent is right here in Ohio. Matter of fact, I will actually play you guys one of the artists that I know that's actually a mentor to me, actually. He's not only a mentor, but he's a very good friend to me. And this guy has helped me since day one. Like, this guy, he's the reason I got as far as I did in music. And this man's name? Zach Keys, also known as Possessed One. So shut your fucking mouths and listen up.
Oh, God.
Number two on the list, Swttling.
Wait a second. You don't know who I am?
One of the darkest underground rappers out to date.
Funny. I bet you didn't get the memo, did you? I'm a different kind of nigga with the killer mental, cannibalistic eating rappers. You're the convicted, even after safe. Scar, tell me, teach from them to live. That's how much I hate y'all. If you fucking with my future, I'll be sure to stop y'all. Street jaws, all claws, face the surface, rap, rap, escape them all. Keep a sign, we may call. Armageddon's coming in, I got plenty napalm. It's my jam, man, I'm about to make you pop. I'm a nice little devil, yeah, I'm always feeling hot. Get the lead in the streets, yeah, I'm lighting up the block. Everybody get running, winning, I'm getting knocks. You'll never see it coming, no destruction with the scars. You'll never see it coming, I'm lighting up the sky. You'll never see it coming, that fire in my eyes. You best start running, I'm getting out of welcome to my cycle, nuclear missile, back to blast off. Call me with your cycle, show these niggas how a body rocks. Don't go make that eye contact, you're gonna make my skin hot. Find out where you live and go and make that man is hot. Find a nigga non-existent, Dr. Dre's detox. No trust for these niggas that form in the false retail. Aim with the deadly vision, I'm busting all the ear trails. He smoked with the devil and he fornicated the mistress. All was a rebel with homicidal intentions. Hell, hell, rock hard. Smoke them all. Charizard. Ain't nobody fucking with a boy like I got too many blast toys. They can't stop me. No, this is my year, man, I'm about to make you cry. Harmonize with the devil, yeah, I'm always feeling hot. Get to lean in the streets, yeah, I'm lighting up the block. Everybody get running, winning, I'm getting knocks. You'll never see it coming, like destruction with the scars. You'll never see it coming, I'm lighting up the scars. You'll never see it coming, like that fire with my eyes. You best start running, I'm getting as wise. Electric flow, hit him with a deadly dose of sapid dose. Put him in a comatose, they never make the after. Creeping around the hood with the Grim Reaper Igor, an entity with a deadly bite, and I'm making die, yo. Swimming in a lake of fire with them sinners burn slow. Welcome to my hellhole. You never saw it coming, but I bet you see it now. And orthodox procedures make the whole world wow. Spitting up blood make the whole mic bleed to like a deadly sound. Looking down on my flag, yeah, I'm making nigga frown. Put a smile on it, bitch, you don't want me to act a clown. This is a serious situation, I am the devil's creation. It's my year, man, I'm about to make you cry. Harmonize with the devil, yeah, I'm always feeling hot. Get to lean in the streets, yeah, I'm lighting up the block. Everybody get running, winning, I'm getting knocks. You'll never see it coming. Destruction in the sky. You'll never see it coming. I'm lighting up the sky. You'll never see it coming. Get that fire in my eyes. You best start running. Armageddon has arrived. This is my year, man. I'm about to make you cry. Harmonize with the devil. Yeah, I'm always feeling hot. Get to lean in the streets. Yeah, I'm lighting up the block. Everybody get running, winning. Armageddon knocks. You'll never see it coming. Destruction in the sky. You'll never see it coming. I'm lighting up the sky. You'll never see it coming.
Next up, my good friend and brother from high school, Matt POV, and this is his song, PTSD, featuring Tech N9ne, man.
Okay, so for this month's box, a Better Man box, for those of you who don't know, I launched a clothing line.
Don't try to talk to me like you know what this is. Yeah, I know I might have symptoms that are familiar to you, but I got this. Thanks anyway.
Don't let this eat me alive. I only can see this world from the inside. And I'm going inside. I can't get you back to let me go. And nothing is making sense. And I have no patience for anything. So I'm going on everything. Somebody hit me out.
See what I see, so how the hell you gonna stop these voices in my head that got me awfully rocky? Do you copy? Traumatized much from homicide, what? Don't wanna flip, but mama, I must be the one that I trust. I ain't got no friend, I ain't got no grin. But I'm macho when I lock load and I block foes in. When I stop souls and I rock hold, I'ma drop those sins. In a box so slim, inside of my not close grim. My hurt, it goes deep, I serve and go weep. A vertical leap when you're alert in your sleep. Was a word of a treatment, somebody murdered. More peace inside of my third, it's so bleak. There's so much dirt, I go leap to cheese.
Don't let this eat me alive. I only can see this world from the inside. And I'm holding it inside. I can catch you, I can let it go. And nothing's making sense. And I have no patience for anything. So I'm going on everything. Somebody get me out of here.
Never be the same, no. I don't wanna be deranged, though. I didn't wanna be changed, but you prayed to let the fame go. I felt the heat inside my chest, you made the solid cause. When I'm off the bottle, I'm on fire like a molotov. I can promise I won't hold emotions, but I'm not sure that when I fall. I've been hurting like a working person, earning dollars, I'm not calling off. Look, I've been working for a better place. I've been running for the second base. So many demons behind me, I don't give a fuck, and I'm running, I let them chase. I woke up, my whole world was different. It always hurts when you hurt me decisions. I see clearly, you blur on my vision. To make a sale, I'll be surely in prison. She cut me deep and I felt the incision. Man, and this ain't poetic justice. When they prescribe me a substance, they take it, quote it, and pump it like it's an ode to the public. I think it's ode to the public. This show's so prolific function. Life speed and talk is to the game. I'm going home with nothing.
Don't let this eat me alive. I only can see this world from the inside. And I'm holding it inside. I can cut you, I can let it go. And nothing's making sense. And I have no patience for anything. So I'm going on everything. Somebody get me out of here.
Next up, to take it to another side, my good friend who I've known for years now, this is my best friend Vinny and his band Charmera. Shout out to Vinny, man. What up, bro?
Thank you. broken. Does anyone else feel dead? Anyone else hear the voices whisper in my head? Does anyone else feel hollow? Does anyone else feel lost? Can anyone else read emotions from their human form? Is anyone else a machine? Is anyone else incomplete? Is anyone else just trying to stay up on their feet? Is anyone else a machine? Is anyone else incomplete? Can anyone else explain what's become of me? Dropping my casket train.
Now, need I say any more about the talent that's out there? Those are just a few people that I know personally that are very good, that deserve a chance to be signed. So like I said, stop running your fucking mouths, shut your mouths, open your ears, and take a look around at the real talent that's around you. Because these people like myself deserve a fair chance. They really do. I deserve a fair chance, and so do they. They don't deserve the bullshit that you give them. They deserve to be signed. And to every artist out there that is being messed with and screwed over by the mainstream industry, I want you guys to know you guys are not alone. I'm right there with you. We're in this shit together. And if you are an artist and shit and you're going through that, share this video around, man. Like, literally, share this around to everyone. I want this to go so fucking viral that they cannot ignore it. I don't want this to be ignored. I want this posted everywhere. And to everybody else out there that's on the grind doing what they do to make money, keep on that grind, man. Especially all you music artists out there, man. Keep on that grind and keep on pushing. Don't let nobody stop you. Keep on going. Because, yeah, the mainstream music industry might be winning this battle right now, but at the end of it, it's the war that we're going to win. We are going to take this and make a change. So just keep fighting, guys. Keep pushing for that change and don't stop no matter what.